Louder.
Hello everyone, this is Biology Insights and we welcome you to another video lecture of the series Inheritance Biology. Whenever we heard inheritance, immediately we think about heredity and genes which are gifted from parents. One more unforgettable name connected to inheritance is Mendel. That's right, father of genetics, a great scientist who gave principles of inheritance and explained dominancies of allele of a gene. Dominance means one allele masks the effect of the other. Time passed, but puzzles of inheritance were attracting researchers more than anything else. When microscope was discovered, genes and their expression were studied in details. It was the time when they got to know that genes are way more complex than how Mendel explained them. Mendel said that there are two alleles for single gene. One is dominant and another is recessive. Look like one allele is doing everything and other one is almost doing nothing to determine the phenotype. But researchers said that this was oversimplification about genes. Moreover, they found some traits which were non-Mendelian, means they were not following the complete dominance rule of Mendel. But what made them rule breakers? Are there any other types of dominancies as well? Well, the answer is yes. And this behavior of gene beyond Mendelism is called extension of Mendelism. Apart from complete dominance, there are three more types of dominancies: incomplete dominance, codominance, and overdominance. One at a time, let's go into incomplete dominance. It was 1905. A German botanist, Karl Korenz, were doing experiments with plant of Mirabilis jalapa, commonly called 4 o'clock, because its flower get open in late afternoon. In his experiment, he crossed homozygous red flower plant with homozygous white flower plant. And interestingly, the offspring had neither red nor white flowers. Rather, it showed pink flowers, an intermediate phenotype. This was like trait blending, and Mendel's dominance rule was not explaining it. When this F1 generation was allowed to self-fertilize, it gave red flower plant, pink flower plants, and white flower plant in a ratio of 1:2:1, which was different from 3:1 ratio of simple Mendel's experiment. This type of allele dominancy showed in F1 generation is called incomplete or partial dominance, which gives an intermediate phenotypic generation. If you find it fascinating, trust me, explanation of why it is occurring is even more interesting. At molecular level, the allele that causes red phenotype is expressing a functional protein required for pigmentation, while the allele for white phenotype, it lacks in protein expression. Now in case of heterozygous, where both the alleles are present, it produces only 50% functional protein, and that is not sufficient to give red phenotype, because 50% of functional protein cannot accomplish the same level of pigment synthesis that 100% protein can. So, it gives intermediate phenotype of pink flowers. Well, this means our opinion of whether a trait is dominant or incomplete dominant may depend on how closely we examine the trait. Remember Mendel's experiment with different seed-shaped plants? A homozygous plant with round seeds was crossed with homozygous plant with wrinkled seeds, and the whole progeny was heterozygous with round seeds. But if we look closer, there is a difference in production of starch grains in seeds. Round seeds have higher number of starch grains than wrinkled seeds. And if we examine heterozygous round seeds under microscope, we will observe that they actually contain intermediate number of starch grains than that of the homozygous round seeds. This is because an intermediate amount of functional protein is expressed in heterozygous, and it is clearly not sufficient to produce as much starch grains as homozygous does. So, more closely we look, more likely we discover that even if heterozygous is phenotypically similar to dominant homozygous, it is not exactly same at the gene expression level. This was all about plants, but do you think we can have incomplete dominance in animals as well? Yes, we can find this phenomenon even in humans. Have you ever seen a person with hazel eye color, mixture of green and brown color? Well, this is because of incomplete dominance. Let's consider that G is allele for green eye color and B is for brown eye color. If they give rise to a progeny, it will have both the alleles having incomplete dominant relationship, which is why the person would have beautiful hazel eyes. Wavy hairs of Labradoodle dogs are also an example. It comes from having straight hair and curly haired parents. Next time you play with a Labradoodle, don't forget to think about the genes. How cute! So far, we have considered examples that has genes exiting two different allelic forms. But researchers have proved that at molecular level within natural population of organisms, most genes have more than two allelic forms called multiple genes. And in those cases, apart from incomplete dominance, sometimes alleles show co-dominance relationship. As the name suggests, co-dominance is like cooperation about dominancy between two alleles, where neither allele is dominant or recessive. Rather, they got expressed together. To understand the concept of co-dominance, let's examine the molecular characteristic of human blood types. How many blood groups do humans have? There are many, but most commonly we consider ABO blood type. The plasma membrane of red blood cells have groups of interconnected oligosaccharides, which act as surface antigens. Antigens are nothing but molecular structure which got recognized by antibodies produced by the immune system. On RBCs, two different kinds of antigens are found, antigen A and antigen B, which are synthesized by allele IA and IB. Gene I is called polymorphic gene, which means it has more than one form. There is a recessive allele for this gene as well, which is symbolized by lowercase I. And if a person is having both recessive alleles, there would be no antigen present on RBCs, which means a person is having O blood group. So, if a person has both IA or IAI alleles, it would be A blood group, because even if recessive allele is present, it cannot express any antigen. Similarly, if a person has both IB or IBI alleles, there would be B blood group. But in case where IA and IB both are present, the blood group would be AB blood group, because here both the alleles contribute independently and equally. This kind of phenomenon in which both alleles expressed in heterozygous individual is called co-dominance. To know inheritance of blood type, let's consider the possible offspring between two parents having IAI and IBI alleles. Combination of different gametes produced by parents give rise to four possible offsprings with blood group AB, A, B and O in 1:1:1:1 ratio. Different from Mendelian results. Let's talk about plants. Rhododendron also shows co-dominance. When red and white flower plants are crossed, the progeny has flowers with white and red patches on it. Beautiful, right? This phenomenon is kind of common in animals like dogs, horses, cattle, which show different color patches on skin. Biology is everywhere, isn't it? Do you think any of this phenomenon is beneficial to organisms? Well, the next phenomenon, overdominance, certainly fall under that category. Overdominance is usually due to two alleles that produce proteins with slightly different amino acids. Sometimes this makes heterozygous a superior trait. For certain genes, heterozygous may have characteristics that are more beneficial for their survival in particular environment. This kind of phenomenon in which heterozygous has greater reproductive success compared to homozygous is called overdominance or heterozygote advantage. A great example of it involves human gene that caused sickle cell anemia. This is an autosomal recessive disorder in which the affected person produces an altered form of protein hemoglobin, which carries oxygen within red blood cells. Normally, people carry HbA allele that produces hemoglobin A, but a person with sickle cell disease would have HbS allele that produces hemoglobin S, which caused their RBC to deform in sickle shape under conditions of low oxygen concentration. If we examine a person with heterozygous allele combination, he is not affected by sickle cell disease, but interestingly, he is resistant to malaria. The protozoan genus Plasmodium that causes malaria spends part of its life cycle within Anopheles mosquito and another part within RBCs of human who have been bitten by the mosquito. Now, RBC of heterozygous individual ruptures when infected by the parasite, and thereby they prevent the parasite from propagating. Wow, this must be feeling like having a secret superpower. Have you ever observed other examples of any of these dominancies around you? Tell us in the comment box. Share this video to your study partner and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Before we get a quick summary of all the dominancies, keep it in mind that this is not all about extension of mandalism. There are other scenarios which are rule breakers as well, like epistasis, incomplete penetration, lethal alleles and so on. To catch each of it, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you will be notifying whenever we introduce them to you. As a quick summary, let's see the main differences between incomplete dominance, codominance and overdominance. Incomplete dominance is when one allele partially masks the effect of the other. In codominance, both the alleles get expressed and none of it is dominant or recessive. They get same opportunity to contribute to the particular phenotype. While in case of overdominance, one of the alleles produces slightly different protein than the other, which lead to superior trait that eventually beneficial to the organism. Thank you for watching the video. See you in the next lecture.